going on, everybody, and welcome back to Locker Room Talk, the original show where the fan gets heard. You're with myself, Greg Baker, Alex Ochoa, and Anthony Padilla.
How's it going?
Huge week in the NBA. LeBron James is coming to the Lakers in 2014. We'll get right back to that. But first, Derek Fisher possibly coming back to the Lakers. There's some opportunity there. Mikey said, nope, we need a young point guard to put on Westbrook at times. Having two point guards who don't play defense won't get the job done. Make him an assistant coach. If not, let him sign elsewhere. Anthony, what do you think about Mikey's comments here and possibly Fish coming back to Lakers?
Hey, Mikey, great comments. Hopefully you're watching the show. But I got to agree. Derek Fisher at 38 years old cannot perform the way he used to be. Now, Laker fans, I know it'd be great to see Derek Fisher come back and end his career in L.A., but the Lakers aren't known for being a good people, a good organization. They're known for winning. They're a winning organization, and they're going to do what it takes. They want to win now, and Derek Fisher's just not that guy. He shot 32% from the three-point line last year and 38% from the field. He averaged 25 minutes a game with the Lakers, and that's just not what we need. And let's not forget his defense. We need someone that's going to come off the bench and be able to hold it down defensively. That's just not Derek Fisher. I don't see him doing it. Don't bring back Derek Fisher.
We'll see. Another guy that agrees with you here is Robert. He says, bad move if Lakers bring him back. Much respect for Fisher. Been with the Lakers for a while, but doesn't have speed like he used to. Alex, yeah, I'm sure you agree with Robert here.
Hey, thanks for the comment, Robert. I totally agree with Robert. Look, let's not get it twisted here. Derek Fisher brings some great qualities to any team. Leadership, championship experience. He's a vet, a voice in the locker room, and can hit the clutch shot at times. But honestly, the truth is you don't want to bring in an old point guard to back up another old point guard. Look, Fisher is past his time. His shot's not like it used to be. And, you know, you need someone there with younger legs that's going to allow the coach, Steve Nash, to get a good rest and come back in there and close out the games. And Derek Fisher, I love you, man, but you just ain't the guy for LA right now.
Well, check this out. Augustine says, I saw the game last Saturday. I'll take D-Fish anytime over Blake, Duhon, Morris, and the rest of the guards coming off the bench to give Nash some rest. Now, most of this I'll agree with here, but Augustine, I don't necessarily agree that Fisher is the guy to give Nash rest. I really think that Fisher could be a good third point guard on our bench. Keep in mind, Steve Blake and Duhon are good trade pieces. I mean, they're expiring contracts, so we could still pick up yet another point guard.
And I'm not saying that Steve Blake or Duhon are that guy that's going to back up Nash, but I got to go with the younger guys. And I'm not saying I like Steve Blake because he hasn't performed up to my expectations. It'd be great if they can do some kind of trade and acquire someone younger. But, like, again, not D-Fish.
Look, I can understand that the Lakers want to save money. And by getting rid of these two players and bringing in Fish for veterans, you know, minimum of $1.4 million, I understand that it work in their advantage. But the Lakers, again, have made it clear that they want to win. And in the offseason, they were supposed to get younger, and all they did was get a little older. So I don't think Derek Fisher is the direction that the Lakers want to go in. Again, it'd be nice to see him end his career in L.A., I just don't see it happening.
I think it's just good mojo for Kobe Bryant. You can't really disagree there.
You know what? Also, there was a lot of Laker fans hitting up us on Twitter and on Facebook, and they were just talking a lot about experience, and he's bringing leadership. We don't need this on this team. We have Kobe Bryant, Antoine Jameson, Steve Nash. I mean, meta world peace. We don't need that.
I don't think you can never have enough experience and leadership on a team.
Not this team. This team has enough of it, man.
Well, let's just say the leadership that Derek Fisher brought, not talking bad against the guy, but if you take it that way, didn't do much for us the last 2 years when he was on the team.
We'll see. Well, that was a starting point guard. We're talking maybe second or third on the bench, but we'll see. We got a question for you guys. Let's say the Lakers end up in the finals this year, as we all hope. Who do you want them to play, Celtics or Miami Heat? Anthony, got an opinion?
You know what? I personally want to see them win their 17th championship, or at least, you know, hit into the finals, possibly a Game 7 series against the Boston Celtics. I'd like no better series, because the last one we saw was fantastic. It was a great series. And let's not forget that the Celtics revamped in the offseason by picking up Jason Terry. They just signed Leonardo Barbosa. I mean, these are two great players, and Jason Terry is by far, if not as good as Ray Allen, a lot better than he is now. The guy can cut. The guy can shoot. I mean, what else do you want?
See, I got to go with the Miami Heat. I mean, it would be great to see the Lakers win a championship against the Boston Celtics and get that 17th one. But I got to go with the best against the best. The best player the last, 10 years, Kobe Bryant, against who the best player is now with LeBron James. LeBron James and company also stacked up with Ray Allen and Rashad Lewis. Lakers stacked up with Dwight and Ash. I would love to see the best against the best and take out the champs. Miami Heat, Lakers is what I want to see in the finals.
I'll be honest, I could care less who they play among those two. They'll both be epic series. However, Eastern Conference Finals are going to be just magical. If it's those two, Celtics and Heat, that's going to be
be
that's
it.
Just going to be awesome.
Real quick, I want to give a shout-out to Derrick Rose. Hopefully, he comes back 100% healthy when he does come back. Great point guard. I think the league is really going to miss him, too, when you speak of the Eastern Conference conference.
Yeah, and playoffs. He's not coming back, though, guys. I'm calling it now. But another question for you guys. Make sure you keep leaving the comments below. Let us know what you think about these questions. But LeBron James, 2014 Lakers, is he going to be replacing Kobe? A lot of GMs are saying that Lakers are headhunting him. Alex, do you think he's a good fit for LA? Can he really come here?
Look, LeBron in his prime is a good fit anywhere. And the best place to land in 2014 or 15 when he's a free agent, LA, Los Angeles. Play next to Dwight, if Dwight stays, which I'm sure he's going to stay because he's going to get a max deal. I'd welcome LeBron James with open arms because he is the best of the best right now.
You know what? A lot can happen within the next 2 years. I personally want to stay in the present and just worry about what's going on right now with the starters that we have right now and winning right now. Would I welcome LeBron James? Absolutely. One, it's not my team. Two, this is LA. Anyone's welcome as long as you're going to help the Los Angeles Lakers win. Is it going to happen? Who knows? He had mentioned when he was with Cleveland that he wanted to play with Chris Paul. So that could play into effect of where Chris Paul is playing. There's still Deron Williams. So a lot plays into it. But from what everyone's saying, the Lakers could be stacking up to make a big move for somebody.
No doubt, no doubt. LeBron in purple and gold just seems kind of crazy right now, but You know, who can argue with that? LeBron and Dwight Howard, that's insane. That'd be a crazy team. That's going to do it for us this week, guys. Make sure you leave a comment below. Let us know what you think of these questions here. At LakersLRT on Twitter, you feel free to send a message there. And make sure you check out Lakers Nation. Plenty of good shows on there. Amy Halverson, Outside the Huddle, that's always a good show. And we'll see you next week. Keep tuning in.